So what is lazy eye? What exactly does it mean and what causes it? Join me in this video as I help you better understand this common eye disease. Let's take a look. Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes and vision. And if you're new here to the channel and you like taking care of your eyes and seeing your best, then definitely hit that subscribe button down below so that you don't miss any of my future videos. Now I'm excited today to be talking about lazy eye because not only is it just one of the most requested video topics I've ever had, but because it is one of the more complex eye conditions that's out there and therefore sometimes pretty difficult for people to grasp. The medical term for lazy eye is pronounced amblyopia, and despite people calling it lazy eye, it's really not much of a problem with the eye at all, as it is an issue with the brain and how the brain has learned to appreciate and see vision with the affected eye. So it's really much more of a neurological condition. Having a lazy eye or amblyopia means that the affected eye is not able to see 20/20 or just very well in general, oftentimes leaving one eye to see very clear and sharp while the other eye sees everything very blurry. And that's even with the very best optical correction. That means not with glasses or with contacts. And a lot of people will ask, hey, could I just get LASIK to correct for my lazy eye? And unfortunately, no, that doesn't work either, because it's not really, again, a problem with the eye, as it is a problem with the visual processing centers of the brain. To better understand how lazy eye is a neurological issue, consider how people are right and left-handed. I myself am extremely right-hand dominant, and that's because at a young age, I started using my right hand to do all of my activities. And over years, my brain started to develop more neural connections to strengthen my right hand. Now, my left hand still functions and works great, but the part of my brain that controls hand movement for my left hand simply just doesn't have as many neural connections as my right hand, therefore leaving my right hand to be very right hand dominant. And that same concept is at play when it comes to lazy eye, meaning if somebody is unable to see clearly early in life as the brain is developing, then it'll never develop as many neural connections as the good, better seeing eye, and may never fully learn the potential to see clearer vision. Now, a very important concept with lazy eye is that when we are young, our brain is said to be more plastic. That means that our brain has more of ability to grow, change, and learn when we are children. And that means that children who go through some sort of treatment for lazy eye or amblyopia often see better results than people who are much older. Now, with that being said, there are plenty of reported cases of adults going through treatment for their lazy eye and still having some improvement. But again, it is much more difficult and we usually don't see it that often, especially in extreme cases. Now, before we go over the different causes of amblyopia, let me know in the comments if you yourself have lazy eye or maybe you know someone who does. What has been your experience with it? I'd love to know. Now, lazy eye can be caused by having a few different ailments with the eyes. Most commonly, people will think of lazy eye as somebody having an eye turn, where the eye may turn inward toward the nose, or maybe it'll turn outward away from the other eye. And in the clinic, we call that having strabismus. And in cases of this wandering eye, oftentimes that person may see double for a short period of time, but the brain will often adapt, starting to suppress or shut off that wandering eye so that they can focus better with the good eye. And in those cases, it's the same thing. Their brain starts to develop more neurological connections with the good, better seeing eye, therefore resulting in amblyopia. And although this happens more rarely, children who are born with congenital cataracts or have some other ocular deformity that occludes their vision, they can also develop a severe form of amblyopia as well. Oftentimes, amblyopia will develop due to uncorrected refractive error, and we call that refractive amblyopia. And that is where somebody will have an eye that just isn't being corrected with glasses or contacts at a young age, and the difference between those two eyes will cause the brain again to develop more neural connections for the better seeing eye, leaving the weaker eye to kind of fall behind. This can occur due to nearsightedness, farsightedness, and astigmatism. It could happen in just one eye or both eyes in extreme cases. Most often though, we see it in children who have an eye that is more hyperopic or farsighted than the other eye. And unfortunately, it does not take that much of a difference to end up with this type of amblyopia. Even more unfortunate is that small children do not speak up to their parents about having poor eyesight. They just haven't learned what good vision really is and isn't. And how often do you see a kid walking around testing their vision between their right and left eyes? It just doesn't happen. And that's one of the reasons why it's recommended that young children have an eye examination with an eye care professional between the ages of 6 and 12 months of life, again around the age of 3, and then again around the age of 5 or 6, or before entering kindergarten, or sooner if a doctor recommends. And that's important because children who are identified with this condition can be treated, and treatment is better when it's performed earlier. Hey, if this video helped you better understand lazy eye or amblyopia, go ahead and hit that like button for me. If you'd like to learn a little bit more on how to treat amblyopia or fix lazy eye, then go ahead and click or tap the screen over here to the side and check out my next video. Or if you'd like to see another cool video here from Dr. Eye Health, go ahead and click or tap the screen down over here. Again, this is Dr. Allen here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes and vision. Keep an eye on it. We'll talk to you soon.